Hello my dear students, in this video I am going to talk about the case study problems regarding the system of linear equations. यहाँ पर हमारे पास एक नेटवर्क गिवन है. इस नेटवर्क को हम नेटवर्क ऑफ रोड्स भी कंसिडर कर सकते हैं, और यहाँ पर जो नंबर्स और वेरिएबल्स गिवन है इनको हम नंबर ऑफ व्हीकल्स पर मिनट कंसिडर कर सकते हैं. क्वेश्चन जो हमारे पास गिवन है दैट इज Find the general flow pattern of the given network, assuming that the flows are all non-negative. What is the largest possible value of x3? यहाँ पर ये जो directions given है, non-negative का क्या मतलब है कि x1 अगर इस direction में है, it means that x1 की value positive जो है, which shows that it goes in this direction, and the vehicles are not allowed to come. In the opposite direction, so we cannot take the negative values of x1. The value of x1, x2, x3 and x4 are always greater than or equal to 0. One way traffic है यहाँ पर, ठीक है? तो पहले तो हम general flow pattern find करेंगे इस network का. So strategy क्या है इसका general flow pattern find करने की? हम यहाँ पर 3 intersection points हैं. Let's label them as intersection A, इंटरसेक्शन बी एंड इंटरसेक्शन सी. अब यहाँ पर हम इन तीन इंटरसेक्शन पर फाइंड करेंगे कि व्हाट इज द फ्लो इन एंड व्हाट इज द फ्लो आउट. सो एट द इंटरसेक्शन ए द फ्लो व्हिच इज कमिंग इन इज 80 and the flow out at the intersection A is x1 and x2. So x1 plus x2, और अब यहाँ पर ये जो values है x1 plus x2 that should be equals to 80. What does it mean? कि अगर 80 vehicles intersection A में enter हो रही हैं, तो जो out होंगी number of vehicles that should be equals to 80, right? So the number of vehicles coming into the intersection A should be equals to the number of vehicles going out of intersection A. So x1 plus x2 should be equals to 80. Similarly, at the intersection B, the flow coming in is x2 and the flow going out is x3 and x4. Applying the same strategy that the flow coming in to the intersection B should be equals to the flow going out of the intersection B. So they should be equal. Similarly, at the intersection C, the flow coming in is x1 and x3. So x1 plus x3, and that should be equals to the flowing the flow going out. So that should be equals to 20. Okay, and the last condition which we should apply is on the whole network, means the number of vehicles coming into this network, not at the specific intersection, but into this network should be equals to the number of vehicles going out of this network. यहाँ पर तीन entry और exit points हैं. ये entry point है, ये exit point है, यहाँ पर जो 20 लिखा हुआ है, और ये x4, ये 20 point. So we can write down as 80 is coming in, 20 is going out, and x4 is going out. So 80 should be equals to 20 plus x4. This implies that x4 is equals to 80 minus 20, which is equals to 60. It means that the first equation which we get is x1 plus x2. Total number of variables are 4, x1, x2, x3 and x4. We don't have any number for x3 and x4, and that is equals to 80. For the second equation, we have x2 minus x3 minus x4 is equals to 0. And then we have x1 plus x3 is equals to 20, and finally we have x4 is equals to 60. Okay, if we simplify these equations further, we can write down them as x1 plus x2 is equals to 80, x2 minus x3, since we know that x4 is equals to 60, so we can write down this as equals to 60, and then we have x1 plus x3 is equals to 20, and the final equation is x4 is equals to 60. Now, writing this system of linear equation into the matrix form, we can write down it as 1, 1, 0, 0, 80, 0, 1, minus 1, 0, 60, 1, 0, 1, 0, 20, 0, 0, 0, 1, 60, multiplied by x1, x2, x3 is equals to, this should be the coefficient matrix. So this should be the coefficient matrix, okay, and this is the unknown vector x1, x2, x3, x4, and then equals to the constant vector, which is 80, 60, 20, and 60. Right? Now this can be written as ax is equals to b, and if we assume that a sub b is the augmented matrix, then the augmented matrix of this system is written as A sub B is equals to 1, 1, 0, 0, 80, 0, 1, minus 1, 0, 60, this should be 1, 0, 1, 0, 20, 0, 0, 0, 1, 60. Now let's find whether the given system has a solution or not. इसके लिए हम क्या करेंगे, हम इस augmented matrix को convert करेंगे to the echelon form. Echelon form में convert करने के लिए हम इसके ऊपर सीक्वेंस ऑफ एलिमेंट्री रो ऑपरेशंस परफॉर्म करेंगे. इक्लॉन फॉर्म की प्रॉपर्टीज कहती हैं कि जो पिवट एलिमेंट है उसके नीचे जितने भी एलिमेंट्स हैं वो सारे जीरो होने चाहिए. सो दिस इज द पिवट एलिमेंट फॉर द फर्स्ट कॉलम, एंड देन ऑल द एंट्रीज बिलो दैट वन शुड बी जीरो. वी नीड टू मेक दिस वन जीरो बाय अप्लाइंग द एलिमेंट्री रो ऑपरेशन R3 minus R1. So this will be equals to R3 will change. So we'll write R1 first. R2 will remain same. And then R3 will become 1 minus 1, 0. 0 minus 1, minus 1. 1 minus 0, 1. 0 minus 0, 0. 20 minus 80, minus 60. And R4 will remain same. अच्छा, उसके बाद हम इसको further reduce करेंगे. Echelon form में reduce करने के लिए ये first column हमारा भी complete हो गया. ठीक है, ये pivot element है 1, then we have all other elements below that 1 is 0. Then the pivot element of the second row is 1 and all other elements below that 1 should be 0. So we need to make this minus 1 0 by applying the elementary row operation R3 plus R2. R3 will change, so R1 will remain same. 80, 0, 1, minus 1, 0, 60. R3 will be added to R2, so that be 0 plus 0, 0, minus 1 plus 1, 0, 1 minus 1, 0, 0 plus 0, 0, and this will become 0 again. And the fourth row is 0, 0, 0, 1, and this is 60. So next क्या होगा, इक्लॉन फॉर्म की प्रॉपर्टी ये भी है कि अगर इसमें कोई भी जीरो रो मौजूद है दैट शुड बी एट द बॉटम, सो विल शिफ्ट द थर्ड रो टू द पोजीशन ऑफ फोर्थ रो बाय अप्लाइंग द एलिमेंट्री ऑपरेशन R3 4, चेंज रो 3 एंड रो 4 इंटरचेंज, सो विल राइट 1 1 0 0 80 0 1 minus 1 0 60 and then we'll write the fourth row in the place of third row, which is 0 0 0 1 60 and then we'll write 0 0 0 0 0. Okay, now we have now reduced this matrix, augmented matrix, to the echelon form. As you can see that up to this position, these are the coefficients of the matrix A. The rank of the matrix A here you can see that the rank of matrix A is equals to 1, 2, 3. There are 3 non-zero rows in matrix A, and if you can see that the rank of the augmented matrix is also same. There are 3 non-zero rows, but the number of unknown variables is equals to 4, right? So that rank of A and rank of B is less than 4, which is equals to the number of unknowns. This consistency criteria says that the given system is consistent having infinite solutions. अब वो solutions किस तरह से find करेंगे? Let's apply one more elementary row operation on this system and reduce this matrix to reduce echelon form by applying the elementary row operation R1 minus R2, because I want to make the first entry of the second column 0 by using the second row. So this will become 1 0 1 0 20. This will become 0 1 minus 1, 0, 60. This will become 0, 0, 0, 1, 60. And this is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Now if I write the corresponding system of linear equations corresponding to this augmented matrix, that can be written as x1. There is coefficient of x2 is 0, so I am writing this one. Plus x3. Is equals to 20, x2 minus x3 is equals to 60, and x4 is equals to 60. It means that if we find the value of x1 in terms of x3, we can write it as 20 minus x3. X2 is equals to 60 minus X3, and x4 is equals to 60, where this x3 is free variable. The value of x1 and x2 depends on the value of x3. Sorry, this should be x2, so this would be x 60 plus 3, right? अब यहां पर हम x3 की कोई भी वैल्यू यूज कर सकते हैं, लेकिन हमारे पास एक कंडीशन गिवन है क्वेश्चन में कि ये जो फ्लोज हैं, जो वैल्यूज हैं x1, x2, x3 और x4, दे आर नॉन नेगेटिव, राइट? सो अगर हम x3 की वैल्यू 20 पुट करते हैं इधर, तो x1 की वैल्यू क्या होगी? 0. अगर 20 से ग्रेटर वैल्यू सब्स्टिट्यूट करेंगे तो x1 नेगेटिव हो जाएगी. इट मींस वी कैन सब्स्टिट्यूट x3 इज इक्वल टू 20 और द लेसर नंबर, राइट? लेस देन और इक्वल टू 20. सो द वैल्यू ऑफ x3 शुड बी लेस देन और इक्वल टू 20. लेस देन अगर माइनस 20 अगर कंसीडर करें वो भी लेस देन 20 है, लेकिन यहां पर हम लगाएंगे ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू 0, क्योंकि x3 की वैल्यू भी नेगेटिव नहीं होनी चाहिए. सो दैट शुड बी बिटवीन 0 एंड 20. दिस इज द कंडीशन व्हिच इज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन. अब यहां पर अगर हम फॉर एग्जाम्पल अस्यूम करें, इफ नाउ दिस इज द जनरल फ्लो पैटर्न, राइट? दिस इज द जनरल सॉल्यूशन ऑफ द गिवन सिस्टम, गिवन नेटवर्क नेटवर्क. सो इफ वी सपोज x3 इज इक्वल टू एनी वैल्यू इन दिस इंटरवल, अस्यूम दैट x3 इज इक्वल टू 10, व्हाट वुड बी द वैल्यू ऑफ x1? x1 इज इक्वल टू 20 माइनस 3, सो दैट वुड बी 10. x2 would be equals to 70 and x4 is equals to 60. Now, just now we saw that according to the given network, we must have x1 plus x2 is equals to 80, x3 plus x4 is equals to x2, and x1 plus x3 should be equals to 20. अगर हम ये values यहाँ पर substitute करेंगे, if we substitute these values into that network, that should satisfy that network. Hence we can say that this is the general solution of the network flow problem. और अगर इसको हम explain करें, what does it mean? That x3 is independent, x3 is free variable here. The value of x1 and x2 depend on the value of x3. And the domain or the value of x3 should be greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 20. x4 की value हमेशा 60 रहेगी. तो इसको अगर हम check करना चाहें, you can take x3 equals to 0, substitute here. Specific अगर हम solution consider करें, तो वो उसको satisfy कर रहा है. Hence, we consider this as the general solution of the given network flow problem. Okay, one more thing. It says that what would be the maximum value of x3? What would be the maximum value of x3? ये हमसे क्वेश्चन में पूछा गया. सो यहां पर आप देख सकते हैं कि x3 की मिनिमम जो वैल्यू है दैट इज 0 एंड द मैक्सिमम वैल्यू ऑफ x3 इज 20. सो यू कैन राइट इन द आंसर हियर दैट द मैक्सिमम पॉसिबल value of x3 is 20. If you have any question regarding this tutorial, you can write in the comment section. I'll try my best to resolve your problems. Thank you.